It's the mother of all mysteries, ladies and gentlemen, the Freedom 251 from Ringing Bells, a phone which has everyone questioning its authenticity. It's just unbelievable in the first place that a 3G smartphone can cost just Rs. 251. And as soon as you accept this fact, you are greeted with all sorts of suspicious details about the phone and the company that's making it. So I'm gonna try and give you a clear picture of the Freedom 251 and all the controversy that's surrounding it at the moment. But before that, the Freedom 251 is this really strange 4-inch device that is trying incredibly hard to look like the iPhone. I mean, it even has iPhone icons on its interface, which could invite copyright troubles from Apple, mind you. And its back has an Indian flag pasted on it. Guess what? We looked it up and that's totally illegal. But let's keep that aside for the time being. The Freedom 251 really does look like an impressive smartphone. I mean, if you're buying something for Rs. 251, how can you even expect it to have a quad core processor and 1GB worth of RAM? Moreover, it's even got a 3.2 megapixel rear camera and a basic selfie camera on it. And then there's 8GB of storage, which can be expanded via a microSD card, which may well cost you more than the phone itself. All these components cannot possibly be sold at Rs. 251. I mean, their combined cost itself is coming to around 2,500 rupees. So how in the world can Ringing Bells manage to do what it's doing right now? We still don't have any answer to that, but what we do have is a series of outrageous facts that you would love to listen to. The Freedom 251 claims to be a made in India device, but it's not. It's made in China. And get this, the Freedom 251 is not even the Freedom 251. It's a phone named Adcom Icon 4, and the units provided to the press after the launch have the Adcom logo covered with whitening ink. We're not kidding. But Ringing Bells has clarified on this, saying that the initial units have been sourced from Adcom and that the final units will indeed be made by them with the same specifications. The funny part is, Adcom isn't even aware of all this. So it's clear now that the Freedom 251 is indeed not made by Ringing Bells, and it only used the Adcom phone because it has the same specifications. But that is not true as well. According to those who have used this model of the Freedom 251, the phone has a 5 megapixel camera, whereas the Freedom 251 is claiming to have a 3.2 megapixel camera. Those who managed to buy the device have been guaranteed deliveries before the end of June this year. Now do remember here that there was no limit to the number of bookings, which means they'll have probably crores of units to deliver before that period, which is a logistical nightmare if not anything else. On top of that, Ringing Bells has been involved in a series of unending troubles. There have been income tax raids, legal questionings, and even an allegation from an enforcement directorate officer about the Freedom 251 being a Ponzi scheme. A couple of days ago, the company made a decision to refund the money collected from the first 30,000 buyers and only accept cash on delivery on its orders. The reason for this has not been officially stated, but it may have something to do with the ED having directed the online payment partners of Ringing Bells not to release any funds until the orders are delivered. Now, despite all these ambiguities, the makers of the Freedom 251 are extremely confident about their product. Ringing Bells President Ashok Chadha tries extremely hard to give a breakup of how they are able to sell the smartphone at Rs. 251, but his explanations are unclear as hell. The other face of the company is Mohit Goel, who has gone on record saying that Ringing Bells will earn a profit of, get this, Rs. 31 off of each Freedom 251 sold. We're not kidding. Well, you can take his word for it or be the same person that you are and, you know, not fall for the scam. Because that's what we really think it is. Everything is incredibly fishy here, and Ringing Bells will only be able to clear its name by delivering the Freedom 251 smartphones it has taken the orders for, which we definitely think is not going to happen. But there's still a tiny bit of hope. So let's see how things pan out. Hey everyone, before you go, we'd just like you to tell us what you thought about this show through the comment section down below. Do make sure to like and share this video and subscribe to our channel as well. Thank you.